Now back to live coverage here at Meadowbank Stadium in Edinburgh for the game against the Clyde Valley Blackhawks. The score at the first half is Clyde Valley 7, the Edinburgh Wolves 0. And it's been absolutely peppered with flags and ill discipline in the first half, and we'd like to see some football. No doubt you would as well. Alan, what did you make of the first half so far?
Well, you kind of summed it up quite nicely there. Both two teams kind of nervous coming out to the beginning of the season, trying to get things going, but a lot of flags there. Just a combination of just lack of attention and, you know, a couple of small instances of people just getting a bit too passionate, a bit too excited for the game, shall we say that. So I'm sure both teams have had words just to settle themselves down, just to pick out the good bits, because in a stop and start game like that, it can be quite hard to actually pick out the good things that you've done. So it takes your coaches to bring them out and summarise them, show you what you're doing well and what we need to fix. So I'm hoping that we'll get a much more fluid game in the second half.
I certainly hope so, yeah. And as we mentioned before, there's a fantastic crowd turned out today. So what, about 200 people arrived here at Meadowbank to watch this game of football?
Yeah, it's great to see guys turning out, especially now that it's sunny. So I saw some stuff online that the team were actually out advertising locally, so they were able to generate a bit more awareness for this game.
Yeah, and I was talking to a few guys before the match, Alan, and they were saying they were out at local schools sending flyers out, trying to get kids interested in the game as well, and there seems to be quite a few kids have turned up today, so hopefully we'll see a new breed of fans to the sport, which is always important.
Yeah, that's good. And also we're hoping that this is happening at other games as well, so, you know, let's know who's got the biggest crowd today. Like, you know, if you're a venue and you've got a few hundred or a couple hundred, let us know. Maybe even send us a photo if you're in the stands. Let's see how you're celebrating football. Good luck to all the teams competing around the country. Had a couple of scores come in so far, but it's roughly approaching half time now, so we'll give you more score updates throughout this second half here in Edinburgh, so you can have all your scores right together in one place here on Gridiron TV. Remember, you can follow us on Twitter, which is @Gridiron_TV. Tweet us any messages or any questions you like. You can also leave us a message on our Facebook page, so just search for Gridiron TV, like the page, and you can see our updates as well as what our fans are saying, and you can even leave your own messages on there too. If you actually want to get involved in the show, or actually want to get a bit more information on UK American football from wherever you're watching, you can also email us at info@gridirontv.co.uk. So any questions about the show, if you're a budding producer, editor, cameraman, if you want to be on TV somehow and you want to join our team in promoting this great sport, then do let us know. Also, if you've got any just general questions about how the league works over here, if you're not familiar with the setup of UK American football, then we'll happily help you out and give you some pointers. If you go to our website as well, www.gridirontv.co.uk, you'll catch the live stream, so any future live streams that we do. But also on the tabs at the top, you can see all our old shows and even a list of teams around the UK. So if this is inspiring you to get involved in American football in some way, you can go through that list and see who your local team is. And it's all linked through to their own websites as well, so you can then go through, click through there, and you can contact them, your respective teams, and see how you can get involved as players, coaches. Teams are always looking for volunteers as well, so we see down here in Edinburgh you've got sideline staff doing helping with the chain crews, helping the referees out. You've got guys from the Edinburgh squad who are helping with the water, and little things like that, and crowd management as well. So all the crew are just running back into their positions now for second half, but those are the guys that never get talked about very much, and they're the ones that are vital to running successful clubs.
Absolutely. We mentioned before as well, I mean, look at the referees out there today. We've got a five-man crew, but if you want to get involved with even refereeing as well, you know, you can visit www.bafra.org. That's BAFRA. Obviously, the score there still Doncaster 19, the Caesars 0, which we're hearing there. So it's obviously Doncaster are looking to try and win that one and complete that out. And Shropshire Revolution's 23, Lincolnshire Bombers 16 at the moment. So it looks like a big game there. I said a close game as well, almost 7 points in that one.
Yeah, that could be an exciting finish now.
It certainly can be, yeah. Yeah,
so holding the lead, but it could go at any moment.
Well, the game here at 7-0 Blackhawks. Edinburgh looking to kick off.
Our sun's gone away slightly, wind's still here, so we've still got the same kind of weather challenges as the first half, but let's see what the kickers in particular can do.
So we're just waiting for both teams to get themselves ready.
Hi.
we just wait for the referees to get everything set in place now. This looks like Stephen Hogg to kick for Edinburgh.
Yeah, Salim Ahmed, I'm going to have to hold it for him because the wind's that strong here at the moment. So it's.
So here we go, second half football in Edinburgh. Clyde Valley currently leading 7-0.
See if you can predict a score on this one, because we can't. I can tell you that much right now. Send us a tweet, let us know what you think the final score is going to be here. Great kick off there from the Edinburgh Wolves. The ball moves right back
into the corner. Picked up at the half-yard line.
And he's dropped
Bobbled,
it.
Picked up again. Manages to duck through a few tackles there, so saves himself a little bit out to the 15-yard line. So not too bad all in all, but a bit nervous there.
Yeah, Duncan Tara came steaming through the middle there, and you know, he was lucky to get away with Duncan. I've been tackled with Duncan a couple of times, and I can tell you it's not pleasant.
No, special teams is very different. If you've never played special teams, you don't understand the kind of aspects involved, because normally offense and defense, you've just got guys running forward and back essentially. Special teams, you can have tackles coming from anywhere, so you've really got to be paying attention.
Yeah, so it looks like the Blackhawks have got the first down on their own 15-yard line at the moment. So with James Keogh looking to take the snap here, like the hands it off to G-Mac, he moves up the middle, but he's tackled, probably gain about 3 yards there. So it's now going to be second and 7 for the Blackhawks. To be extremely careful in this second half of football as well. What they don't want to do is go behind yet another score and give themselves a mountain to climb, really.
That's right. Ross Young and Mike Roger at cornerbacks here. And now dropping the pass, throwing.
Keogh looks wide as
complete.
Great reception.
To Orr, Keogh carry it through the middle, tackled at halfway there.
Again, about 30 yards.
We just said there, Ross Young there in the corner. Try to get his hand in there, just couldn't quite get in. So the pass made it with just enough power on it. Caught it and was wide open to gain another 10 yards or so on the play.
Yeah, so it's now first down on the 50-yard line for Clyde Valley. Great opening section there for the Blackhawks. Moving the chains well. Keogh looking up and finding his man.
It's a sweep left.
Callum Woods. Looks like a loss of about a yard.
Wrapped up well there by Ross Young.
It's just really important that the Wolves bring in the pressure early. They can't give up any yardage at all right now. They'll need to try and get a pick, they need to try and get a fumble. Recover this football and try and get a score back as quickly as they possibly can.
Dropping back to pass, Keogh. Holmes right now throws right. Caught there at number 85, so Rich Moore takes that about 5 yards.
Pass out to the right hand side to Rich Moore there, number 85. It's caught.
It's getting 4 yards, it's third and 6 at the moment. Will's not getting up too much at the moment, but still, you know, Keogh's, he's using receivers effectively enough.
They're taking their time. You can see the slow pace of them compared to Edinburgh, really taking their time to try and find what they want. So, good control of the tempo by the quarterback.
Absolutely, and that's absolutely key. And you can see that by the two receptions he's had to both his receivers recently.
Drops back, pumps again, and caught on his knees. That will be a first down there. Twenty, Dominic Lewis.
Yeah, another first down for the Blackhawks. Blackhawks moving the chains really well here at the moment. That's three key receptions they've had, and the Edinburgh Wolves really haven't had anybody in the vicinity for coverage.
No, you can see Keogh dropping back, likes to pump fake the ball. He's doing it pretty much on every throw there, so trying to just freeze the corners, freeze the defensive backs and the linebackers into a position where the receivers can then make another move just to get into that gap for whatever coverage the defense have. So he's making space for his receivers.
That's a great hands off to G-Mac. He's brought down on the outfield there.
Yeah, that wasn't going anywhere. Good coverage.
Richard Anderson, great tackle. That's a loss of about 9 yards. Yeah. So it's now second and 19 for the Clyde Valley. There's great pressure by Richard Anderson there. You know, brings him down. He sees it. He reads it well.
He does. Yeah, he's making plays now. He's played in different positions for this team. I think he's now a defensive lineman, defensive end. So he's fitting in that position well with Coach Edmondson. Already made a couple of big plays for loss.
Not only is he quick though, Alan, as well, he reads the game extremely well, which always helps.
Yeah. And now they're dropping back to pass again. Swings this one out left to the back, who cuts inside, beats two tackles.
That's Callum Woods with a reception. And he's just short of the first down by the linesman's marked us.
So a few missed tackles there by Edinburgh, which they'll need to stump out right now. It's one thing to bring the pressure, but you need to have the tackles to cover it up, otherwise you're just going to expose yourself, leave them plenty of room to run into.
Beg your pardon, it's now actually 3-11 to be fair.
Yeah, so almost back to where they started.
Yep. And they've done well, Clyde Valley. They've come out here and they've showed intent straight up from the kickoff.
Yeah, they've obviously seen something in the backfield where they realise they can pass. And he's going to pass again. Play action, throwing out to his right.
Oh, a great reception from David Ott.
Got a tackle by.
Again, that's now 4-1.
Well down there, tackled by Paul McEwen. So here we go, 4th-and-1 on a 24-yard line. You would think they'd have the confidence to go for it on this one.
Yeah, I think they will.
All fucked.
And they've actually given the first down. They've actually, that was just short.
Yeah, they have actually corrected themselves, so it is a first down after all.
Well, they marked that just short of the first down, but they've given it now. So that's now 1st-and-10 on the Emerald's 23-yard line. So the Blackhawks moving this really well at the moment at the start of the second half. Yeah, just as you went off there, folks, G-Mac got a great run there for a gain of about 7 yards, so it's now 2nd-and-3. Clyde Valley playing extremely well in the second half so far.
Yeah, you can see they're good at moving the ball down the field, mixing it up. Run up through the middle there, breaks the second tackle.
Touchdown, Clyde Valley.
Touchdown into the backfield. Said it earlier, missed tackles. It's cost them more points.
That's Phil McCabe. And thoroughly deserved. I mean, they've come out here, they've shown their intentions, they've put the Edinburgh Rolls in the back foot, and it's paid off.
Absolutely. Good physical drive all the way up the fields. Very few mistakes as well. So they obviously worked on that. Cut out the mistakes, and you can see what the difference it makes already.
Doesn't the Edinburgh Wolves just seem to have their heads down at the moment? They just not seem to be, you know, they seem to be a couple of yards off every Blackhawks player at the moment. They're just not getting in their faces. They're not, you know, getting to position to make the tackles.
No, that's right. They need to be a bit more aggressive on defence, understand what they're trying to do on offence, these pump fakes, these play actions, double moves and so on, and just, you know, break harder out and react to the ball more. And make those plays. We saw number 55, Jamie McLaughlin, there limp off injured, so potential injury worries for Clyde Valley. But in the meantime, they're going for the extra point here. And it's Tam Chapman, the kicker once again.
And David Orr, the holder. Chapman kicks that. Looks like that's wide right. Oh, they've given it.
Yep, he just squeezed it in, so that's good.
Yep. So that's 14-0 to Clyde Valley, and Edinburgh Wolves have got a mountain to climb now. There's still a lot of time in this ball game yet, but
something that your veterans need to be talking about as well, just to remind the rookies, saying, look, it's only just gone in the second half. Yeah, we're 2 scores down, but we've still got loads of time. Yeah, they've got enough time to score 10 if they get their act together really, really well. So making sure that the leaders on the team are talking to the young guys and just saying, keep your heads up, we're fine, you have a short memory. Make sure you don't linger on any mistakes that you've made or any errors. Just earn it back next time.
A big update here from the juniors game is Lancashire Longhorns and the Highland Wildcats have drawn 6 each.
It's good. So make sure you keep your score updates coming in from around the country. Just tag us at gridiron_TV.
Yeah, half time at Revolution 26, the Lancashire Bombers 16.
Standing there, lead slightly. Comfortable for the Revs. Meanwhile, this kickoff goes through the hands of the returner around the back, but we've got the whistle blown dead, so looks like we've got a re-kick coming up.
So still at the Keep Moat Stadium, it's half time there. It's still the Doncaster Mustangs 19, the Nottingham Caesars 0.
It's good for them.
It's the only scores we have for you at the moment, so make sure you keep tweeting us at gridiron_TV. So 14-0 here in Edinburgh to Clyde Valley Blackhawks. Edinburgh have got a lot of work to do now to try and get back into this ball game. And we've got Ross Young and we've got Stuart Harrison in the backfield looking to receive.
So here we go with the re-kick.
To Chapman.
Short now to the right side, and it will be Harrison to pick up the ball.
Great block there by Ross Young. And it goes out of bounds about their own 20-yard line. So the Edinburgh Wolves now, no doubt they'll have a lot to talk about to try and come up with some game plan to get back into this game.
So here comes the offence now. The spread formation they've had all game so far. You look out there and you see a number of the players that we've seen in the semi-finals last year against Sheffield Predators, so guys that have been with the team with success before. Let's see if they can keep that going. And Morrison takes the ball himself for a gain of a couple of yards there.
Yeah, we see Clyde Valley going with 3-4 defence as well. Tim Morrison kept that there, got to gain a couple of yards.
What's that? So now ball goes out to the left side to Stuart Galloway. Tackle there for a gain of a couple of yards. Now third down and about 3 or 4. So that brings up third down and short for the Wolves, and they're going to keep their no-huddle offense going, try and get this ball going quickly.
Yeah, maybe they need to start having a huddle and trying to think about things rather than just going straight off.
Oh, there you go. Clyde Valley jumping all over it now, understanding how to bring the pressure, and Morrison takes the first sack of the day, which brings up fourth down. So yeah, we have seen the Blackhawks make adjustments themselves, so maybe something for the Wolves defensive staff to... the offensive staff, excuse me, to have a look at and think maybe we need to just slow things down and just match the pace of Clyde Valley to see if that's going to throw them off a bit further.
I think they should as well, Alan. They need to really look at this offense right now because it's not working. It's simply not working. They need to maybe just take their time. What Clyde Valley are doing, Clyde Valley are controlling their huddle. They're coming out, they're getting things right, they've cut out the mistakes we're making in the first half, and it's been effective. Now, they've also sent out the punt team. So, you know, it certainly looks like... Clyde Valley are going to get the second offensive drive off this half.
Yep. Good punt there from Cameron.
That's Callum Woods.
At the 30 yard line, ducking and dodging again.
Oh, he's dropped it, it's fumbled. Picked up by Edinburgh Wolves.
Stripped as he got tackled there, and it is Richard Anderson picks up the recovery. And once again, another special teams turnover. So, for all the things they can't get going on offense, they're certainly making up for it on special teams, Stuart, and that's incredible to see. Great hustle downfield, taking the ball off the Blackhawks this time and giving the offensive possession back inside Blackhawks' half.
But this is the thing though, the Wolves' defence have had the back foot in the ground, the special teams have got 3 turnovers now in this game. You know, they're the only ones kind of performing out there. The offence really need to step up to the plate, need to start making, you know, start executing the plays now and start getting scores. If they don't do it soon, they're going to lose this game completely, and they cannot afford to do that. I know it's only the first game, but they have to start off with a win.
Screen pass out to Harrison for a gain of a couple.
Second and
Torsion takes the slip pass. Get catch. Dodge back to pass, completes to Alondra, who breaks a tackle and gains the first down.
Yep. Good reception there by Jorge. Really good reception. What was good, didn't give it up, Alan. He caught the ball, he spun, and he managed to get the extra couple of yards as well to get the first down. So, you know, really important for the Wolves right now.
So first down, Morrison drops the pass, throws left side, incomplete, intended again for Harrison.
He's really not having any luck at all connecting with Stuart Harrison in this game at all, is he?
No, that's a connection that's, that really needs to get working as well, because he's finding him out in the flats on the outside, also down in the middle as well, so changing up, he's in that slot receiver position, so same with the tight ends and slot receivers, it can be quite difficult to cover because they've got so much ground to work inside or out.
The thing is, as well, he's got lots of time. He's got good protection in the pocket.
There's Morrison running himself here, so again, a bit of blocking up front.
Yeah, there's no need for him to really hurry with these passes sometimes. He's got good protection in the pocket. He's got plenty of time to try and pick out his receivers and go down his picks. And Stuart Harrison's been open several times. He's just not on his top of wavelength. Sometimes Stuart Harrison's a bit too quick. Sometimes he's behind him, he's in front of him. But they need to do something to try and sort this out quickly. And if they can start connecting, start getting a few yards, get a few downs, he can come back into this.
Absolutely. So momentum stalling slightly in the game as well, just a bit jumpy here, but get back into it. Third down and three to go. Morrison takes it, looking to pass into corner of the end zone. Incomplete, attended for Alonso again. So that's fourth down. And again, looks like they may go for it here. They are in field goal range.
They have no choice. They have to go for it.
They've got the confidence to try and get the first touchdown on the board.
The two receivers on that right-hand side, that's Stuart Harrison, Jorge. And had one cornerback in between the two of them, they should have caught that.
Morrison looking to keep himself, but a timeout called just before a snap by Edinburgh. So, coach not happy with what he's seen there. Possibly so, it looked like they were going to be under pressure there. Morrison looked like he was going to lose that one, lose a sack or lose a loss.
Don Emerson will not be happy at all with what he's seen at the moment. You and I both know we've been coached by Coach Emerson before. And we know at this stage of the game, if you're behind, he's not happy. And he'll be wanting players to step up to the plate now and really show why they're in this team. Yep. Especially the veterans as well. You know, there's rookies out there, so I mean, there's going to be time for the rookies to come in. But the veterans really need to say to themselves, look, you know, we've been here before, we can do this. Yep. But they're not doing it. And that's a big issue for Don Emerson. He will not be happy with that.
No, you can see one or two of them walking up and down the lines, having a chat with what looks like the younger guys, the rookie guys. On the sideline, so just keeping them motivated, you know. Like I said, not to panic. We've still got a lot of time in this game for either team to anything can happen. Really.
Absolutely, and that's the key thing. I mean, unfortunately, a couple of times, Jim Morrison has panicked when he's ready to throw the ball, but he's got good protection. He's got time to step up, have a look at his receivers, go down his line of picks, and try and put the guy as wide open. If he's not, he keeps setting the runs. Fine.
So here we go. Fourth down, three. Morrison takes the snap. Throws a swing out to the right. Stephen Wilson catches that one at about the first down mark, so we'll just check to see where the ball's placed there. It was short, so we have a turnover on downs. Clyde Valley coming back out on offense.
Honestly, don't know what now the Wolves can do.
Well, I think there's still a good chance for them to get back into this. We kept the game, we've had a couple of key interceptions for Clyde Valley, so they've made the most on defence. And a couple of near interceptions on the Wolves' defence as well, so they've tried to take advantage of it. But the second half, Keogh's made a good few passes, so they're starting to connect with his receivers, and that's a run up the middle there, but stuff not really yep. Going anywhere.
That was G-back Conor Evans with a tackle. He stops That's it. See what the defence can do here now. We've gained about a yard for the Blackhawks, so it's now 2nd and 9. I've got to say, I've been quite impressed with GMAC from the number 21 off the Blackhawks. It's been a really good game.
Play action this time. Looking forward to the right.
That's incomplete pass.
There, intended for number 14 there, David Orr. Covered by number 3, Mike Roger. I think the key really for the Wolves here, the Keogh, the quarterback, is he's got plenty of time to throw, so the key is really getting more pressure through the middle of the defensive line. You can't give him the time to make these deep throws or to let the receivers come open against the second or third move. We are with 3rd down and 9 on the 20-yard line. Going to be a sweep now and a reverse. Reverse going to the left side, but this one's read quickly now. Wrapped up well there by Paul McEwen there, intended. It was number 20, Dominic Lewis, who took the reverse there. But no gain this time, so that brings up 4th down, and here comes special teams again. So,
yep, Stuart Harrison going to go back into the backfield.
See if you can see if the special teams coordinator for Clyde Valley has got his fingers crossed in this one, perhaps.
Well, yeah, but the thing is, the rules don't turn these over, and that's a simple thing. Clyde Valley have, and you know, this will probably bounce in front of Stuart Harrison again. He's always had the time to pick it up and move it, and we'll see what happens here. Well, yep, he's got the distance this time. It's gone over his head, never mind drop in front of him, just needs to let that go.
That rolls down to 20 yard line, so good kick there. Taking it all the way down to the Wolves 20.
Coming up on the 20 yard line, then the Wolves offense. I'll take over from there. 1st and 10, Edinburgh Wolves.
Your 1st and 10 for Edinburgh, currently trailing 40-0 here at Meadowbank Stadium in Edinburgh. You're joining us live on Gridiron TV. Thank you very much for joining us today. We hope you're enjoying this second half of football. Remember, you can always get in touch with us. Follow us on Twitter at gridiron_TV. Probably the quickest way to drop us a little message. If you're at another game from around the country, let us know the scores or what the weather's like, or just, you know, how you think the game's going. You can also drop us a message on our Facebook page, which I know a lot of you are actually just reading through the list here. Some comments following the game, so that's always good. Just like us on Facebook as well.
Well, Wolves now 20-yard line. The handoff to Wilson. He's tackled in the backfield there by number 78. 73, sorry, Jamie Weir is the tackle on Wilson. It's a second, it's no gain, it's 2nd and 10. Not a big pardon, that's a loss of big pardon, it's a loss of 4 yards. It's now 2nd and 14. So the Wolves again not executing here in their offensive plays. Just having a word with Wilson there, Jamie Morrison. Going for the pass.
Deep, what you doing? Underneath the receiver, in and out the hands of Alonso there. That was a good scramble by Morrison there to get away from the pressure. Looked upfield.
Straight off his pads, Alan, as well.
Yeah, the defender fell down right in front of him. Number 7, Nicky Farrell. Looked like he was in good position to intercept. He gets his 3rd interception of the day, but just slipped. I don't think the receiver was expecting that, but that's two big.
See, that's jobs. I don't like people saying that he doesn't expect that. As a receiver, you should be expecting it. Simple. You know, as they always say, you always go for the ball at the highest point. And when that cornerback fell, he should be anticipating that. And he really should be anticipating that, and he shouldn't be catching up his pads either, which is your schoolboy error.
It's Morrison deep again.
That should have been a flag there.
Intercepted over through the receiver.
There was pass interference there. The referees didn't see it.
William McLaughlin comes up with the interception.
Yep. Duncan Tanner was actually held back in his arm as he made the run through on his route.
He did look a little bit tangled there.
But it wasn't given. It's been intercepted. It's 1st down Blackhawks.
Yep, 1st down just around about halfway line. Good to see the Wolves actually looking to go deep and try and attack the defence and get big yardage. So here comes the Blackhawks for 1st down and 10.
First and 10 Blackhawks.
Keogh still under centre. Handoff left to...
There's a flag on the play as well.
Callum Woods bouncing it outside up to past the first down marker. And inside 30 yards.
There's a flag, we'll see what the referee's going to call here. I just wonder what Don Edmondson's saying to his team now, and what he's saying to the coaches, you know, what adjustments they're going to make.
It's a false start against Clyde Valley, so this one is coming back. I think he's trying to keep his cool here. He's calling plays himself. But he just needs to rely on his staff to communicate to the players. He didn't get tied up in that. You know, he can give encouragement to the team, but he needs his staff right now to just isolate individuals if it needs to talk with them.
I see a lot of time they're using the hand signals as well, and you know, sometimes that could be lost in translation. So, you know, is that working? Are they basically, you know, maybe signaling the wrong thing? We don't know.
So we go now first down and 15.
Does Keogh just get final instructions from his sideline? Again, he hands that off to Callum Woods.
On the left side there for a gain of about 5 before he slammed back to the ground.
So that's the second and 10 for Clyde Valley. Duncan Tanner being replaced by Dan Cameron. These penalties keep on again, Alan.
Yep, well, we thought we had it sorted there. A really good drive earlier where they just went with virtually no penalties and they ended up scoring. Now they're back to the ways of false starts and distractions, so going backwards at a pretty steady rate here.
But this is where the rules need to be punishing. You know, they need to be, you know, if you've got them on the back foot, they're making the mistakes, the rules have to start punishing.
So first down in about 20 or so. Keogh dropping to pass, swings it out to the right.
An incomplete pass.
Incomplete there, intended for the running back, under pressure again by defensive lineman.
Yeah, Phil McCabe. Phil McCabe is intended receiver. Kind of behind him though, so we'll always see what Keogh comes up with this time round. So still second and long.
Second down, and the wind's picking up again.
Keogh just giving instructions to his running backs now.
Hand off left side, trying to bounce it outside.
Yeah, it's the GMAC again, but he was tackled.
Good outside coverage here by Paul McEwen there. Good outside coverage by Wolves defence now, trying to shut down his outside sweeps and runs.
Yeah, the Wolves defence are coming back into it now. They're making the tackles, they're reading the plays, and they're not letting, like GMAC, as I say, has had a cracking game, GMAC, but you know, they're kind of beginning to read them now. They're beginning to read the offence, and they're starting to make the tackles where they have to be made, not into their own half, but sort of near the line of scrimmage where it should be done. And that's really important, and that's given, you know, it's now third and long for the Blackhawks. Yep. And as long as they keep them here, they'll go for the punt and they'll try and get a good return.
Yep. Third down and long here. See if Keogh takes this one to the air. Well, it's going to be third down and even longer after another Blackhawks false start there on the left side where the receivers and a couple of linemen went as well.
It looks like Richard Anderson giving a little foot movement there just to draw the guy offside. And that's been effective. So still third down, you know, you can still make a big play out of this. But we'll see what they've got to come up with now.
Dropping back to pass now, throws it high up the right side for a jump ball.
To Dominic Lewis there, intended receiver, but it's way too far in front of him.
Good coverage over the top by the safety down corner, so it's going to make fourth down, and no doubt special teams unit out again.
Yeah, absolutely. You're not going to take a chance on this and give away good field position. Absolutely not. And it'll come out. Stuart Harrison again is up on the 27 yard line, looking to receive. So you just got to be careful it doesn't go over his head again like last time, because the wind's picking up, so the ball's going to hang in the air.
Sure, yeah, as a returner, you need to be aware of the movement of the ball and the wind around you, so make sure that it's a lot easier to run forward onto the ball than it is to run backwards and get it lost on your head.
Absolutely right, Alan. It's all about your environment. This one's going to drop just in front of him, but it's going to go out of bounds. Runs about the 23-yard line.
Kick there.
That's the right thing, just keep it away from the kicker, because we know Stuart Harrison gets the ball in his hands, he's got good speed and he's good agility as well. So
actually looks like number 44, Chris Moore.
Oh, it's Chris Moore. Again, Chris still got good speed, still good agility, and it's really important. If you've got someone like that you're kicking towards, you put it, it's like Devin Hester in the NFL, you keep it away from him. You know, he's one of the most potent returners in the game. And that's the end of the third quarter.
End of the third quarter here in Edinburgh, and still 14-0 to the Blackhawks. So one more quarter of football here in Edinburgh on this opening weekend of BAFA National Leagues. Remember, you can keep tweeting us. We've got a few tweets coming in already, so thanks to all our viewers that are watching. You can tweet us at gridiron_TV. If you prefer Facebook or email, just get on Facebook and search for Gridiron TV. Or email us at info@gridirontv.co.uk. Remember, you can also visit the website for a list of teams in your area. So if you've been inspired to start playing football or get involved, just visit www.gridirontv.co.uk.
And I know, obviously, looking at this game, you might not be too inspired, but I can assure you. Oh!
That's Darren Jimmy Morrison stepping up out of pressure intended for 92 Sean Hanlon there. Bobbled in and out of his hands. So incomplete. Second down and 10. Play action throwing over the middle. Incomplete there.
Good coverage again by Clyde Valley. There's Willie McLaughlin. Great covers on Stuart Harrison. Didn't give him any chance to try and get that reception on the post route. We're still third and 10 now. Just trying to find this elusive score that they've not been able to get all game. Still trailing 14-0.
Takes a snap, throws left side. It's ended for Hanlon and almost intercepted. That one could have gone all the way to the end zone. 91 there, Stevie Anderson. Nearly with the interception.
Yeah, the Wolves again, punting again. The offense just have not been at the races today at all. It kind of seems to be their Achilles heel right now, Alan.
It does, just getting that timing going, getting them to connect. Well, it's fourth down here, and punting team just getting ready to go. As Morrison actually steps in as a punter, gets the ball away.
Yeah, and that bounces just in front of Dominic Lewis, who decides to let that go.
Rolling around at his feet there. Wolves eventually recover it just on the other side of the 30-yard line, down to the Clyde Valley 29-yard line, where they'll take over on downs.
Well, it's not been working for Jay Morrison at quarterback. I wonder if Don might even try Dan Cameron, who has been, you know, he's played quite well for the Edinburgh Uni team that he's played for in the off-season. I wonder if he'll turn to him to see if he maybe try and execute some pass plays.
Yeah, possibly.
Need to change something. It's not working right now, so.
Well, we can see them huddled on the sideline there, just having a chat about things just now, just to see all they need to do as an offence to get going. So having a chat there with the offensive coordinators to try and come up with a plan, either, like you said, change of personnel or change of tactics. Or
I think change of personnel would probably be the most likely option, simply because the receivers are getting open, Alan. There's number 22 for the Blackhawks, it's Callum Woods. Takes that on the outside, gets a gain of about 3 yards. Yeah, I think you're looking at the receivers are getting open, they're finding the space, but the quarterback isn't connecting with him. Now, he's just obviously having an off day. We know how, you know, kind of quality that Jamie Morrison brings to the game. He's an absolute athlete, he's got a good arm, but today he's just not happening. So I think, you know, no disrespect to the kid, I think you bring someone else a bit more experience in.
Definitely, and actually sometimes it can work to your favour in your tactics if you can balance yourself between your first and second quarterbacks, or even your third quarterback, if they all have different properties. If you've got runners or deep passers or just different skills, which also throws off the defence, because they need to understand what these new guys bring onto the field.
Yeah, no, that's absolutely right, Alan. And there's Keogh now. He hands that off to Callum Woods, who's drawn up this left side.
Down the sideline, it's a foot race one-on-one, and it's a touchdown.
Callum Woods, fantastic touchdown.
Touchdown to Clyde Valley there, breaking more tackles. And that's the difference, really.
It has been a difference. And you know, it just, a great offensive move. He comes on the outside in the sweep. All the space he's got, runs it for 60 yards, straight up into the end zone. Absolutely no one there to challenge, no one to make the tackles. Wolves are just, they're gone, they're finished for the day, I'm afraid.
So with that touchdown, the Blackhawks start the lead 20 points to 0.
Well, see, apart from the penalties that Clyde Valley have given away, they're all disciplined in the first half, and a couple in this half. They've actually had they've played a good game of football, Clyde Valley. They've done the right things, and they've done the simple things right, which is what Edinburgh haven't done.
And that goes straight down the middle, so it's now 21 points to 0, and you're right, they had a pretty well-rounded game so far now. Contributions on all sides of the ball, so that's been a key difference here. He's been able to execute on offence and get his points on the board. Take advantage of these big plays.
Yeah, absolutely. And you know, Edinburgh, you look at the team now, you look at the sidelines, they look absolutely dejected. You know, I think, you know, the coaches will try and pick them up as much as they possibly can, but they know themselves they haven't done it right, and I think they'll be kicking themselves for that thing. But what do they want to try and do? If they don't win this game, at least try and get a score about back and try and get a bit of confidence moving into the next game. Still a full quarter to play. Silly things have happened in these kind of games before, and you know, if they can maybe get an early score back right now, bit of confidence, get our heads back up and get back into the game, and try and, you know, maybe get a forced fumble, try and get a pick six or something, just to try and, you know, take it to the very end of the game. And we don't know. We don't know what's going to happen, but what I've seen so far, I don't think it is going to happen. I'm being perfectly frank. You see what you want about the conditions, but both teams have to play in these conditions, so there's no excuse there. The wind, both teams have played in it, and then, you know, the Clyde Valley have done the right thing. They've tried the onside kick there.
That's covered well there, so
so that was John Young there, picked that up. So let's see if they bring Jamie Morrison back in, or they're going to go with Dan Cameron. We'll soon find out. Now it's Jamie Morrison still coming out.
Sometimes in these situations, if you're on offense or offense coordinator, even though it's down, you're struggling, you're in a difficult position, it can take some of the pressure off you, ironically, to just relax and just to play your game. You know, you're not focusing too much on tactics, you just want to go out and play football.
There's
an example of just what's going wrong for the offense here. Just
it's confidence, Alan. It's confidence. You know, Callum Buchan is an experienced player, and he'll know he should have had that reception. It's in out of his hands. There's no immediate coverage on him. And, you know, he's let it go. Now, that's purely confidence.
Yeah.
It's all that's down to. It's not down to skill. You know, it's getting in their heads now, and that's dangerous, because then it could be... See, there you go.
And intercepted, trying to throw over the middle. Intercepted there by number 91.
Stevie Anderson.
Stevie Anderson comes up with the interception there.
Be the most experienced player in the league, and if your confidence is not down, we see a miss pass opportunity there, in and out of the hands of Callum Buchan, boom, straight for interception.
Yep. So that's difficult for the Wolves, but good news for the Blackhawks. They lead 21-0 at the moment in this match, and the game position there inside the Wolves half, so they'll be looking to try to get back in the end zone, keep pushing on this advantage that they've got.
you know, 21-0 to the Blackhawks, and they've got a first down now on the Wolves' 25-yard line. And a great interception, right across the middle, and he takes it back for another 15-20 yards.
So your hands are off left now, breaking through the middle.
Yeah, that's G-Mac again.
Good game, about 8 or 9 yards there.
Yeah, it's just shot the first down, Alan. G-Mac, I thought, has been outstanding today. He's been the best player on this pitch so far. You know, Keogh's done well. He's controlled his offense well. He's mixed it up with the pass and the run. But G-Mac, for me, you know, he's been outstanding today. Outstanding.
So now, obviously, Clyde Valley will be happy to take the time, start controlling the clock. It's getting towards that situation in the fourth quarter where you start thinking about time management and clock management.
I mean, what's really important in this game as well, it's not the fact that they've scored 21 points, it's the fact that they've kept a clean sheet so far. And that'll be huge for them, you know, to come and win the game, first and foremost, but to go away with a clean sheet, added bonus. Added bonus for them.
So hand off this time, going right side, round to the edge. Tackled at about the 10-yard line, and that will be a first down for them.
Yeah, that's right inside their end zone. So again, about 5 yards there for Clyde Valley.
Tackled there by Kevin Smith, 26.
I reckon Clyde Valley have got another touchdown here. You can feel it. You can feel it coming. Edinburgh are struggling to contain them. You know, compared to the defence I had last year, the defence last year was solid. And unfortunately, this time they're just full of holes, and they're just, you know, they're finding the gaps. Clyde Valley, and they're punishing them. Keogh now, look at trying to punish the Wolves even more.
And about the middle, not going anywhere this time, just gain of 1 or 0.
Yeah, that was Callum Woods there.
Pace certainly slowing down in this game, just trying to wind down the clock and close this one out. Second down and 10 on the 10-yard line, just outside the 10-yard line. Passes left side, complete
to Richie Moore.
Complete to Richie Moore there. Gang tackle for gain of about 6 or 7 there, so that's inside the 5-yard line then.
Yeah, so we're now down to third and goal.
Third down
and 2 to go.
Third down and 2. They can, in theory, make a first down here, first down and goal. They're at a couple inches between the first down marker and the goal line, but we'll see what they come up with. Third down, handoff up the middle, trying to bounce
to G-Mac. Yeah, he's team tackled there again by the Wolves. So the goal line defence is holding up well at the moment. I know the Wolves are down a few players as well. Scott Hackett left during the off season, and obviously James Foster's taken a season out after his injury last year, and Sam Kemp, the other one, backs out for the season due to ligament damage. So, you know, there are quite a few veteran players out at the moment, but you know what, they've still got a team there that's capable of winning football games, but unfortunately they've not turned up today.
Yeah, difficult day for them so far. They need to kind of salvage what they can here. It's fourth down here, so they've got one more chance to hold Clyde Valley out.
And pass.
Nearly intercepted there, looking for the click slant into the end zone.
Yeah, Paul McEwen done really well there, read the cover as well. He's came across, tried to intercept it, it's bounced off his pads and gone, but still, you know, good defence by the Wolves.
Good stand there, turns over, so that gives the offence for the Wolves another chance to drive. Whilst we've got this moment, let's have a quick chat about the rest of the upcoming National League. So this year, obviously, had the restructure of the league.
Yep.
So you've got more Premiership teams and the National League. So What are your thoughts on the teams that have made it up from Division 1 last year, or even Division 2 now, competing in this Premiership against teams that have got a higher calibre?
It's tough going. You know, I've spoken to like the guys at Willie White from the Saxons, who I'm good friends with, and you know, I chatted to him, and they're a good side, the Saxons, don't get me wrong, and they were luckily, you know, they were beaten in the final by the Sheffield, who again were promoted to the Premier North. I think the Saxons have got it tougher. They're up against three London teams as well. So,
well, there's the handoff to the right side, trying to get out of the end zone, but he's tackled in the end zone, and that's going to be a safety. So a safety for Clyde Valley. So that's going to bring the score to 23-0 now for Clyde Valley.
Yeah, we see. So Alan, we're talking about obviously the Saxons, they're moving up to Premier North. South, beg your pardon. They're up against London Blitz Warriors. Two teams that you're going to fancy to win the division, certainly. London O's, Ricky, will have them. You know, hopefully have them back in contention again. You've got the Bristol Aztecs. All teams who have been in the Premier Division for a long time, I think they'll find it difficult, but they've got the personnel to cope with that. I think they'll probably finish around about mid table. Sheffield, not so sure about. I'm not so sure about the Sheffield. I think they'll got a good side. They've got a good player in David Saul as well. You know, we see him playing in the Uni Leagues. A very, very good, competent quarterback. So it'll be interesting to see, will they stick to that double wing? Will they change it up? I don't know. But they're up against the guys like, you know, East Kilbride Pirates, West Coast Trojans, you know, Doncaster Mustangs, teams like that. So they're going to find that difficult as well as the Birmingham Bulls. So it'll be interesting. It'll be very interesting to see how they cope. Some teams might find it tougher than others. But, you know, good luck to them, and I wish them all the very best in their promotions. But here right now, the National North, the Edinburgh Wolves have been taught a lesson in football today. Simple.
Yeah, we'll see more games coming up of these two as well. So DC Presidents and Gateshead also in Glasgow and Dundee. So a lot of exciting matches to come up. I'm sure here in Meadowbank as well as across the country. But we'll be going around the country, we'll keeping you informed with live games throughout the season, so try and bring the action into your own home.
Yeah, we'll try and get around the country as much as we possibly can. Be sure we're taking as much football as we can as well.
Yeah, Dominic Lewis receiving a kickoff. Trying to get right more missed tackles. And back up to the halfway line there.
Dominic Lewis there. Pick up the ball on his own 24-yard line.
A little update from our friends over in Belgium. The Belgian Bowl finished. Tribes 14. There's the Gators 14, the Tribes 7. So the Gators win the Belgian Bowl.
Congratulations to them.
So, and the score here, Doncaster Mustangs are up 25-0 against the Nottingham Caesars as well. So Doncaster Mustangs certainly starting off with an explosion and sending a message out to the rest of the Premier North.
Well, absolutely, and competing against Nottingham, who were very good last year in Division 1. Another tough lesson for them to start the season, but too early to call, really, if it's going to prove too much of a challenge for them or not, or maybe just one glitch of the day.
That's a change at Alan Moose. An update coming through. It's now 25-7 to Doncaster. Caesar's got a score back.
Good to get on the board. Here we see Kaibai trying to move the ball, but it's not really getting anything up the middle.
Chapman gets the ball and tries to go down the middle.
Still out on the story of the weekend though is Swindon Storm. Rookies to the National Leagues winning 7-0 yesterday.
Absolutely, yeah, congratulations to them. That's the perfect way to start. Hopefully they can keep that going throughout the season. It's going to be a difficult season for any young team, but a big confidence boost for the mayor.
Absolutely, absolutely. And we see G-Mac again with the ball. Gets a gain of about another 5-6 yards.
Tackled by 21. Tackled by 21. Dan Cameron there for the Wolves.
So it's now third and three for the Blackhawks, who lead this game 23-0.
Third down, about 3 yards to go. Hand off through the middle here. Breaks more tackles. And gets the first down.
Yeah, it's Callum Woods again. Gets again about 5 yards. That's now first down on the Wolves' 35 yard line. Or 36 yard line, big pardon.
It's going to be tough viewing for the coaching staff of this defence to look back over this film, but some really important lessons to take from it. They'll need to sit down as a unit and just figure out exactly what they were missing today.
Absolutely, Alan, and I think that's key. You know, it's going to be a lot of classroom work coming up in the next few weeks for the Edinburgh Wolves, and to be fair, it's not like them, to be honest, and I don't understand what's gone wrong today, but something has, and I think that's something the coaches need to sit down and discuss in the coming days, and, you know, and certainly giving feedback to the players and, you know, what didn't work well, what did work well.
And after the middle there, going nowhere but backwards.
Yep. That looks like a loss of about 7 yards there.
John Young with the tackle.
Yep, Callum Woods with the carry, but not so much a carry, not so much the roll back. So that's now 2nd and 15.
Yards to go. Sweep going round to the right here. Mark again. Gains maybe one or two on the play. Still third down and long coming up.
Right hand side, gains a couple of yards.
Yeah, what I'd like to see, Alan, is the Wolves get the ball back again and young Jamie Morrison maybe throw for a nice reception for a touchdown and give the young kid a little bit more confidence going into the next game. This game's gone for them, unfortunately. They're 23 points behind. I don't think they're going to come back from this. But for young Morrison, as a young quarterback, he's only 21 years old. Now, let's remember that. He's only been playing, you know, senior football for a couple of years now. I think confidence there, and I think the coaching staff need to take him aside and maybe try and work on a few things between him and the receivers. But he's got potential, he'd be a very, very good quarterback.
Third down and long here, bouncing to the outside again. Mark down towards the first down. It will be a first down, he just passed the line there.
Yeah, he's dragged out of bounds here by Paul McEwen for the Wolves, number 12. So that will be a first down.
Two or three missed tackles on that one.
Yeah, this is the thing as well, Alan, it's all about form tackling. You can't go out tackling with your arms. You've got to really get your body across the player, wrap up and bring him down. The Blackhawks have the first down on the Wolves' 25 yard line. Keogh, he hands that off to number 28, that's Phil McCabe. Phil McCabe takes the ball up and he's tackled by number 43, it's Edgy Wusso.
Phil McCabe on the run there down the centre, number 28. Gains about 7 yards.
So that's now 2nd and 3 for the Blackhawks, who lead this game 23-0. Apologise, I lost the pictures there, but we're back. I'd like to appreciate you joining us today. I apologise for the issues we had in the first half, but we're back in action again. Hope you've enjoyed this game here from Edinburgh. Not if you're an Edinburgh fan, you're not, but...
Tackle there by John Young. So if you joined us late on today, you've only seen part of the game. Remind you that the full game will be going up online later, so keep an eye out for Gridiron TV for our announcements. So if you haven't seen the whole game, you can catch it all on demand.
On demand? It's pay-per-view. It's tenner each.
Somebody will demand to see this again.
Yeah, it will be up online later for you to view, folks.
So a third down sweep coming to the left side.
There's a carry there by Phil McCabe. He'll get that first down now for the Blackhawks.
Another first down there.
So that'll be on the Wolves' 14 yard line. The Blackhawks will want to get another score here and really kind of build up their points for average as well.
Yeah, they have driven most of the field here, so they've still got the momentum to keep pushing here.
It's kind of a 50-50 first half, but you know, the Blackhawks have just dominated the second half.
So in these early stages of the season, it's really about who can adapt quicker, who can take the information from the first half and work out the best way to beat the other team. So a hand off into the middle. Not going anywhere in particular there.
Yeah, well, that's the GMAC again. You got no gain, that's second and 10 still.
Ryan Kerr, number 60 in there on the tackle.
And that's a 2-minute warning here at Meadowbank Stadium in Edinburgh. It's, the score here is Clyde Valley Blackhawks 23, the Edinburgh Wolves 0.
So send us through any thoughts on your wrap up for as we close up the game here. Through Twitter at Gridiron_TV or through Facebook if you prefer. Likewise, if you want to get involved in football or even want to get involved in Gridiron TV, you can send us an email to info@gridirontv.co.uk. Play goes left side, sweeping left side, breaking a couple of tackles. And down towards the goal line, just up to the goal line, but there was a flag thrown earlier before that. The ball spotted inside the 1 yard line, so he was just short of there, but let's see what the flag was for. And it's for a holding penalty against Clyde Valley, so that's what's going to come back there.
Well, just an update on the scores here, Alan. The Shropshire Revolution are 33 points up against 22 over the Lincolnshire Bombers. That's moving into the third quarter. In fact, moving into the fourth quarter, I beg your pardon. So, a big game there.
Second down and about 20 now for Clyde Valley. 24 yards out from the goal line. So, see what they come up with this time.
Just a full-time result here for you. Over in Ireland, we've got the Craigavon Cowboys are playing against the Belfast Trojans, and the Trojans win 52-7. So big result there for the Irish champions.
Big shout out to Gordon Curry, who's watching online. Thanks for joining us. Thanks for being one of the many, and also Alan Henderson. And even Stephen Woodcock, who's watching all the way from New Zealand, an ex-Wolves player, so he's, we're glad we can bring you coverage of your team, Steve, all the way in New Zealand.
Yeah, just unfortunate they're not playing very well right now.
Yeah, it's about as far away as you can get, but far away from a good result as you'd want it to be. But
I'm sure half of these players would want to be in New Zealand right now once Don Edmondson gets her hands on them full time.
That's a timeout called there. Yeah,
it's good to see an old friend of mine, Alistair Pullen, as well, an ex-player, you know, coming back to coach as well. It's good to see him back in the game. There's a timeout here in the field. Just over a minute left to play in this game. Still 23-0 Clyde Valley. Moving towards the end of this game, Alan, you know, we see a few, you know, individual performances by players on the field. And who do you think your MVP of today is?
Well, it's certainly going to be someone on the Clyde Valley offense. They've really taken advantage of their opportunities, and we've seen them getting better and better throughout the game. Just opening up more holes, especially for the running back. So Mac, which we want to see, Mac has probably been my standout player in terms of just his yardage and tough running.
I absolutely agree with you as well. And I thought Keogh, the quarterback's done a cracking game as well. He's done well, he's commanded his offence very well. And he has executed his passes, and his, you know, his handoffs have been immaculate.
There, another 5, 6, 7 missed tackles there. Really, really tough stuff from a defence there. And Clyde Valley kind of running at will right through the middle of them there.
Yeah, it looked like McCabe.
28, Phil McCabe there with the carry. Brings up fourth down at about 4. Give a big shout out to one of my co-presenters, big good friends, Tommy McGeorge. Apologies for missing you out in the last round of updates, but I'm sure he's pleased that you're watching.
Yeah, Tommy, if you want to take up the game, you can try and find a team on our webpage.
So, fourth down and three, inside the Wolves' 10-yard line. It's another big stand for the Wolves' defence here. But it's actually the field goal unit that's brought out. So.
Yep, there's Chapman again. His kicking's been excellent today. He's kicked everything he's waiting for. Snap's good, ball's good, and it's good.
Up through the middle, so another 3 points to add on to the score. That makes it 26 points to nil to Clyde Valley.
The uprights, 3 points gained. Blackhawks 26, and the Wolves 0.
I've got to say, this wasn't a score that I would have predicted this weekend, I can assure you that much.
I think it's certainly surprised a lot of people. It's traditionally been very close between these two teams, so a bit of a one-sided affair, especially for the second half. It's really, really difficult on the Wolves, but as we see across the league, it's not necessarily an indicator of what's going to happen through the rest of the season. We could see exactly the opposite the next time these two teams face, which is what's kind of great about it. It's, you know, you can never really predict what's going to happen each week here in the National Leagues.
No, you're right, Alan. You know, this league is wide open. There's so many good teams here. What I'm kind of keen on seeing this season is in this division, certainly, is the DC Presidents. Now, they've got what I believe to be around about 90 registered players in their team. A lot of rookies, a lot of veteran players there as well. And I'll be interested to see what they bring to the league this year.
Definitely, it's a testament to organisations to how well they can manage themselves. In terms of, you know, the committees and backroom staff, to be able to do the recruitment and holding on to guys who really want to be involved in the squad, even if it's guys who never even played a game yet or about to play their first game, they obviously see something in the club that they want to be involved in. So another onside kick attempt there, just one little chip up into the air.
Caught down. Clyde Valley, but caught by Jorge Alonso.
An easy catch there, and sticks up to just inside their own half.
And we will be updating you very shortly in the coming weeks on what games we'll be looking to attend. To cover live as well.
TV's website.
So first down for the Wolves inside their own half, looking for a consolation score here. Morrison dropping back to pass, throwing deep, and
almost intercepted by Willie McLaughlin in the backfield. That ball came down with snow on it, Alan. You should have caught that, to be honest.
Obviously not entirely sure where that was intended for. There was in between the receivers.
Yep, so it's now still 2nd and 10 for the Wolves. Let's see what Jamie Morrison can produce here. Again, he's going for the pass. He runs out and bootlegs right.
Just to keep himself.
And he's got it out of bounds. Yep.
So let's look at this game in terms of turnovers, and we really see actual. It's quite clear that both teams have found it difficult to get going, especially the Wolves turning over interceptions. But Clyde Valley, a lot of turnovers on special teams. So
yeah, that's the thing. The Wolves have had the opportunities. You know, it's been there for them for the taking. And there's Jorge Alonso, just a reception for a game of about a yard. Yeah, it's been there for the taking for the Wolves. They've turned them over three times on special teams, and they've not really capitalised on that.
No, it's something they really need to learn to strike and take advantage of that as soon as they get turnover. But likewise, it's the Clyde Valley defence that have been winning turnovers.
Well, that's full time here at Meadowbank Stadium. The Clyde Valley Blackhawks have won the game 26 points to 0 against the Edinburgh Wolves, and you know, certainly was a cracking second half. Well, The game's all over here, and it's not something people would have predicted, but you know, all credit to the Clyde Valley Blackhawks. I've come here, come at the second half, the first half, Alan, that was full of mistakes, full of silly little errors. But the coaching and staff have obviously said to them, look guys, let's bring this back to basics, let's just try and execute things correctly, and look what's happened. They've scored 26 points.
Absolutely, that's a really all-rounded performance as well. Really grinding it out on the offence and taking advantage of the fact that Wolves' defence was really struggling with tackling, a lot of missed tackles there. So just taking advantage of that, just grinding the ball through the middle, getting big yards, bigger and bigger runs each time, even though really the defence was in position to make the tackles, they're just not doing it. So yeah, that's tough for them.
Yeah, as we mentioned just before the end of the game, it was just turnovers as well. They had opportunities that was there for the taking. They didn't execute well. And I think Don Emerson will take this away. He'll watch game footage. He'll sit down with his coaches, and he will pick holes in this performance today. And knowing Don Emerson really well, both of us have been coached under him, you know the Wolves will come back as a different team the second game.
Well, definitely. Early on in the season, whether it's pre-season or whether it's your first couple of games, there's so much learning to do. Things you didn't realise that were issues with the team until they really get into full speed action in games against other teams. And it's stuff you need to look at. You do need to be critical about it. You do need to look at it and say, find all the issues so you can iron them out as quickly as possible. It's also good for players to actually see themselves on film, to understand what it is that they're doing and what they're not doing, to get the all-round view, to get the coach's view of what's going on the pitch, because it's too easy for you as a player to be really focused on just your one bit on the field and what you have to do. You're not realizing that that you're not meshing together with other parts of your offense or defense or special teams or whatever it is, and you need to just see it from a whole. You need to be open to the criticism. You need to open to learning about what you've done wrong as an individual and as a unit, and just have a short memory about it. Just learn that, correct mistakes during practice, and then be ready for your second game. Try and make up for it as much as possible.
Absolutely. What the Wolves can't afford now is any slip-ups now going forward. They need to try and win all the rest of the games to try and have any chance of winning this division. But then what the Blackhawks have done today, they've not only came here and scored 26 points, as we mentioned before, it's a clean sheet. And for them, for the points advantage, that's exactly what they need to do, is to come away from here with no points against them, and it puts them in a great position going into the next game.
Definitely gives a lot of confidence to the defence that they know that stuff's working. So they can only build on that. But that's not to say that they're going to have easy games all season. They're going to have some tough matches coming up. So they're going to really need to regroup as a team, not let this go to their heads, but just take the confidence away, but also do the learning, like I said there with Edinburgh. Take the learning that they need to correct all those penalties, the false starts, all the problems that set them back, so that come the next game they can try and go 2-0.
And that's it, Alan. Well, what we want is, obviously, we still hear the score, and the Shropshire Revolution are still winning 33-22, and the Doncaster Mustangs are still ahead against the Caesars. But, please, keep tweeting us your scores at Gridiron_TV. Keep us up to date with what scores or games you're at, or if you're listening in, or what scores you do understand that are going ahead. So, keep it tuned to Gridiron TV. We will be releasing very shortly lists of games we'll be looking to attend and to stream live. So please make sure you tune in to Gridiron TV on Facebook, and say Twitter at Gridiron_TV, and our website www.gridirontv.co.uk.
Yeah, so just pass on a message of thanks to everyone here in Edinburgh for hosting us at Meadowbank Stadium and the Edinburgh Wolves. And like you said, we are going to keep you updated on where we're going to be, so you're going to see us just like last year around the country. Could be visiting your team, so give us a shout if you want to be the next team to be live here on Gridiron TV. So thanks very much for tuning in. We hope you have a good evening. Once again, we finish out here our coverage of Edinburgh's Clyde Valley Blackhawks take away the first victory of their season against the Edinburgh Wolves.
Thanks for joining us, and we'll catch you again soon.